Tonight, a special PBS broadcast called After Newtown begins a national dialogue about the issues raised by that tragedy. Gwen Ifill will host this evening's collaboration of our national news and science programs. Yesterday, she sat down with Education Secretary Arne Duncan for the special. It was the former Chicago Public School Superintendent's first interview since the killings. Here's part of their conversation.
Secretary Duncan, where does the responsibility lie for action here?
Gwen, it lies on all of us as parents, as community leaders, as religious leaders, as political leaders. No one gets a pass in this, and this is not a time to, you know, to point fingers or lay blame. And, you know, often these things, there's lots of inclinations to do that, but this is complex. And anyone who wants to sort of say there's a simple answer here, I think, does a grave disservice to the complexity and the urgency of fundamentally trying to make our country a safer place for our children.
The president has asked the committee that you will be on, that Vice President Biden is going to spearhead, to come up with solutions or approaches within a month before the State of the Union speech. Do you worry that the outrage is going to fade before that happens?
I don't worry about the outrage fading. I worry about our collective courage to break through. And again, for me and for so many people, unfortunately, in this country, this is not a new issue. We've been fighting this issue for a long, long time. In Chicago, we buried a child killed to gun violence every 2 weeks. Think about that, Gwen. Every 2 weeks, we buried a child. The vast majority, innocent children, one at their birthday party, you know, in the afternoon. The vast majority aren't gangbangers. And so I think this distinction.
But outside of that neighborhood, it goes unremarked upon mostly.
So that's what I worry about, is that the lack of courage, the lack of willingness to break through. We have an endemic here, and we need to change that in a very fundamental way. And as I said, for the horror and the anguish and the pain, I do think the world has shifted. I think people have a sense that enough is enough, and when you have, you know, 20 babies and 6 teachers and principals killed in a matter of seconds, a minute, I mean, in such a short amount of time, in a very peaceful, very safe community, everyone in this country, this has touched people in a different way, everyone in this country feels vulnerable and want something better for their own children.
And most policy leaders like you and even individuals have said this isn't just about guns, this isn't just about mental health, it's a nuanced solution.
It's very complicated. I think one of the other risks or dangers is to oversimplify. So do we need, you know, less guns, not more? Absolutely. The president talked, you know, the other day about a ban on assault weapons. We have to look at the gun issue very, very seriously. But that by itself, an important piece of the equation, but not the answer by itself. And we have to talk about mental health. We have to talk about school safety. We have to talk about parent and community responsibility. For better or worse, in these mass shootings, the profile of the shooters are remarkably similar. And when we have young people in our communities who are hurting, who are ostracized, who are bullied, who need mental health services and don't receive them, there's a grave, grave cost that we as a society pay. You know, I actually have a lot of confidence in our country at the end of the day. And I think given this horrendous tragedy, I'm optimistic. I can't guarantee, but I'm optimistic that we can get our country to a much, much better place. And our children, and our families, and our communities, they deserve no less.
Put yourself in the shoes of school superintendents, school principals, school administrators around the country now, trying to figure out what to do, how to speak to this. What to do, how to speak.
I think you have to do a number of things. First of all, you have to have honest conversations with our children. And if they're scared, if they're afraid, finding lots of different vehicles, avenues for them to address that fear, whether it's talking about it, whether it's writing about it, whether it's drawing about it. I think the worst thing you can do is sort of sweep this all under the rug. Our children are smart. They watch TV. They read the newspapers. They listen. And I would doubt there's a child in this country who isn't thinking about this. And I know my 2 young children are thinking about this quite a lot. We have to help teachers and principals deal with their own fears And, you know, they don't want to be in the line of fire. You know, they could easily, they see themselves as those teachers who got killed, as that principal who got killed. And what can we do to help the adults, you know, deal with those difficult issues? How do we help those children, those families who are, we know are on the margins, who are struggling? How do we get them, not just as a school system, but as a community? How do we get them the help and the support they need so that they don't end up in this kind of situation? And then finally, how do we make sure our schools are absolutely as safe as possible? Our schools have been forever these safe havens, safest places, often safest places in the community. And we need to continue to do everything in our power to make sure that they are.
Mr. Secretary, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Much more of Gwen's interview will air later tonight in a PBS special broadcast. You can watch the entire interview with Secretary Duncan online.